Hola, buenos dias. Here we are again. We're talking about these pronouns, this furniture removers list, the indirect, and the shoot at me direct. Okay? So, what I'd like you to do is I'd like to show you a little bit more about how the pronouns, how they work in comparison to English. Okay? Because you see, when we look at a book typically, and it's got mete, le, nos, os, les, okay, what they'll tend to say is that those pronouns are me, you, him, her, and sometimes they'll say to me, to you, to him, to her. That's it. Okay, they don't really go into much more, but you know those pronouns, mete, le, nos, os, les, they have a lot more work than just that. They aren't just me and to me, okay? There are more things. So I'm just going to show you a few examples of what other things they mean. Okay, they're all about the same, but they have what are called different prepositions, these little, you know, the word to, with, for, by, in, on. These are all prepositions, okay? So these pronouns have different prepositions in English. Okay, let me show you. So we'll start with the basic one, okay? We'll start with the basic one. Okay, le digo algo. Okay, le digo algo. Okay, so I say something to him, Okay, so the le to him, and obviously it could also be to her, yeah, unless you are a laísta. Okay, so to him or to her, so le digo algo. So that's one thing it can mean to. I hope we can see, yes we can. So it can be to, that's one way that we can have the pronoun working, like if you compare it to English, okay. But what about this one? So, le mando algo. Okay? Now that is, I send him something. Okay, can you see the difference? And this applies to the same. This could be, I send something to him. Or, I send him something. I send him something. So, what you can get to him, or it can just be him or her. Obviously her here as well. So it can be to, or can just be him or her. It depends on how you structure your sentence. I send something to him, I send him something. Okay. Really, this one is I send him something because of the structure of it. All right, but that's not the end of it. There are more ways that there are more of these little words that go in front of the preposition. Let me show you something. Okay, let me see. I'll take this off now. If you need to see that again, you just go back in the video. Isn't it marvelous, eh? Modern technology. Now, what about this one? Right, now maybe you've seen this one. Okay, se me cayó la taza. Now what that sentence is saying is this. Here, se cayó la taza. The cup fell, that's what it's saying. And then what you do is you put yourself in there to show that it actually fell. You dropped it, basically. Let's not beat around the bush. You dropped the cup, okay? But the Spanish have a very clever way of doing this. Spanish speakers, I should say. And that is that they put the blame on the cup. Isn't that fantastic? Yeah? And so what this is, the cup fell from me. Okay? So look, this me is now from me. So we've got a from me. Or from him, or from her. See, equally, if you want to say, he dropped the cup, it would be se le cayó. Yeah? So the cup fell from him or from her. Okay? If you wanted to say we dropped the cup, you would just put nos. Se nos cayó la taza. Okay? So this particular job, this pronoun's job, is to be a from. The cup fell from me. It fell from you. Fell from him. Okay? We wouldn't say that in English. We would say, I dropped it. Okay, perhaps we accept our responsibilities a little bit more. But that's how it's a from, okay? But there's more, there's more. Okay, what about this one? Okay, I'm not sure whether I like that sentence, but anyway, just to give you an example. Okay, the car broke. Okay, and I think I might prefer to put averió, broke down. Okay, so how does that sentence, how do we say that sentence in English? Look, it's the same format. Look, the car broke down. Okay. The car broke down, and I'm in there as well. So how would we say that in English? How we say it is, the car broke down on me. Do you know what? The car broke down on me this morning. On me. Okay. So there's something else. Look. On me. And then we've got another structure with these indirect. Okay, what about this one? Le preparo un café. Okay, now that can mean I make him a coffee. But what's the other way that we can say it? I make a coffee for him. So that these pronouns can also be for him, for her, for me, for you. Okay? What I'm aiming to show you is that don't be tied into me and to me, okay? Because the pronouns can, this metele, nosos les, they can mean so much more, okay? So much more than just to me and me. So we've got to him, or from him, or on him, okay? So what you have to do, this is the skill, particularly when you're reading Spanish and you see these kind of constructions, is you've got to try and see how would we say that in how would you say that in your own language? Okay, because sometimes that doesn't translate very well. Okay, the car broke me down. The car broke me down? No. The car broke to me down? No. The car broke down on me. Aha! Yeah. So you have to play around a little bit to find out what it means, what you'll hear. I've got my cuñados here at the moment, okay? Jose is from Tenerife. You've seen him on some of the videos. And Elena, the sister of Cynthia. When I listen, because they're English, they're learning English. They're here in the UK to learn English. As I'm listening to them talk in English, what they do most times is whenever they come across this or anything where they've got an a, they put two. Yeah, they say to me, he is going to call to me. Okay, why? Because in their mind, that's what they've learned, that this pronoun means to me. Okay, and so they say it such a lot. And of course, that isn't how it is. Sometimes it is and sometimes isn't, and sometimes it's many other things. Okay, so in the next video I'm going to show you the same but with the direct verbs. Okay, so I hope that's helped. Maybe at the beginning it might make things more confusing, but I want you to be aware. This is the thing, you see, if you're not aware of other meanings, then it does get confusing later on when you're trying to decipher a sentence and you say, well, I don't, just doesn't make sense when I just put me or to me in. Of course it doesn't. Okay? Pues hasta luego. Nos vemos pronto.